Can this tabletop pellet grill produce a quality skill level 10 brisket? Let's go ahead and find out.
We've got that hopper slam full way up over the grates. Primer's going. It's going to switch over to an efficient burn. And the first thing we're going to do is leave this in the smoke mode. We're going to leave it in the smoke mode for at least 4 hours to get that smoke ring to set or establish. And the theory or principle that we're using in this is that the smoke that you're going to get and the flavor and the ring that you're going to get essentially sits in for the first 4 to 5 hours. Everything from that point forward is pretty much just bonus. If you watch till the end, we'll talk about how many pellets we ended up using, how many times we had to fill back up, as well as the boat method. Everyone talks about the fear of this unit catching on fire with heavy grease and fat, failure to keep it clean. Well, keeping it clean, check the block. Since we don't have to worry about keeping the unit clean, we're going to control the fat and the accumulation with this boat method. The boat method is creating a cradle of foil that captures all the fat and grease, keeps it in the cook, as well as leaving the top open. Leaving the top open allows that bark to set and establish. You can see that we've got that smoker set on smoke, and we're hitting that 4 hour mark. With that 4 hour mark, we're gonna check on the pellets, see that we've burned probably a little bit less than a quarter, refill, then go ahead and move into that boat method.
If you like the content that you're getting in this, we're gonna go ahead and do a playlist specifically about the A-Smoke recipes. And if you really ask for it, down below, wings could be next.
This brisket, we did do a salt, pepper, garlic powder, onion powder dusting on this to add to the spices. We also did an injection with Better Than Bouillon beef bouillon and did it fat cap down, or the point down. So it's a bit strange to have the point facing down during the smoke. Usually you put that up and the fat filters down through the meat or across the meat and your flat is down. But this brisket was a bit awkward when we bought it. I didn't do any trimming on this. This is what it looked like. Just barely fit in. Didn't have to do that trimming, and did the scoring on top to increase the surface area, a little bit of the eye appeal, as well as it's a great way to guide once that bark gets real thick. Sometimes it's tough to tell which way the striations are going in the meat. You put that crosshatch in, you know exactly which direction to cut to go directly perpendicular to the grain of the meat when you're slicing. Be careful with your probes. I did have to guide them past. I tried to go over the top, but with that divider, it was too difficult to get the quartz to slide through. So I went across the front of the hopper here and it worked out perfectly. I did burn up a set of cables when I had a flare up once before. Nothing dangerous. It just so happened where it flared up, it ended up burning the cable and I had to buy a new probe. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and crank that temperature up, get it up to a good cooking temperature, somewhere around 250, 300, depending on how it's reacting. We'll monitor it to make certain it's not getting too high, and we'll get set up for that boat method. Now you can actually see that all those delicious juices will gather inside of that, basically that tray or that boat that you've established here. It keeps the meat moist. The fat isn't dripping out of the chamber anymore or gathering in the cup. While that was sitting in there finishing off the cook in the evening, we went ahead out and did some deer hunting. There's a whole bunch of deer hunting in this channel. A lot of the cleaning, cooking that we do, venison cooking, a whole playlist just dedicated to venison. Well, we went out into the woods to squeeze in a quick archery hunt and noticed that we found some lion's mane. If you ever see this in the woods, do not pass it up. It's literally the lobster or crab of the woods. It tastes phenomenal. The texture's great. We go ahead. It was a rainy, kind of a rainy, wet day. So we drain some of the moisture out by putting it on a paper towel, and the moisture drops out of the mushroom. Just a light cleanup. And you got to check how this cook comes out. It was well into the dark when we were finally able to pull this off, and after the hunt, it took, I would say, somewhere around 14 or 15 hours to get this cook done. The bark turned out fantastic. Just look at that. And wait till you see the smoke ring, how it comes out as well. There's an additional benefit of using this boat method, and that's the beef tallow that ends up being caught in the boat. Don't throw that away. People pay good money for beef tallow. We end up cooking those mushrooms in that beef fat, and with the smoky flavor of it, you've got a really neat addition of beef fat, kind of like cooking with pork lard. Don't waste it. Use it. It's clean, fresh, nice smoke flavor to it. Seriously, I'm not even kidding. Smoked beef tallow in wild-picked lion's mane mushroom. Absolutely unbelievable. Now let's get back to that portable pellet grill smoked brisket. Interesting fact, lion's mane is one of those foolproof mushrooms that doesn't have any lookalikes. If you know the basics of what you're looking for, you can find this without worry. And we did give this brisket plenty of time to rest, maybe 2 hours, hour and a half, 2 hours in a cooler, allowed that meat to relax, and just check out these results.
That's good brisket.
Well, let's talk about the pellets for a second. So we did end up filling up maybe 1 3/4 times, maybe twice, and emptied this out. So you do have to monitor it. You're not gonna get one cook on one load of pellets. I did wanna take a quick second and show you doing that foil wrap over the panel that sits above the fire pot makes both cleanup much easier, as well as with that boat method. Notice how clean that foil is. You just peel it off, you're down to bare clean metal underneath and helping to prevent that fire. And then you throw on top of this some of that wild lion's mane mushroom fried in the beef tallow from the brisket. I'm actually on low carb right now, so this is a perfect meal, extremely satisfying. Mm. So YouTube says that this video is perfect for your viewing habits. This is my latest upload, and over here is a playlist you might just enjoy. I hope you liked it. If you did, please click like, subscribe, share, and come on back for more.